Blackstone Audio presents Them, a novel by Nathan McCall. To Paula. And there are those who have the truth within them, but they tell it not in words. Khalil Gibran. Part 1. Chapter 1. April 15th. 4:36. Barlowe Reed drove down an Atlanta Parkway, heading south toward North Avenue. The car, a battered old Plymouth with sagging pipes, had seen its best days 10 years before. Barlowe drove it slowly, like he halfway didn't want to go in the direction he was moving in. He chugged along, a twinge of irritation tugging at him. It had nothing to do with the young boy riding his bumper. Barlowe was always annoyed about one thing or another, usually some item he'd read in the paper. The source of this latest vexation, though, was more personal than headlines in the daily paper. Ever since he'd gone downtown that afternoon to pick up his income tax returns, his mood had soured. Barlowe hated paying taxes. He couldn't explain it in fancy words, but the reasons were clear enough inside his head. Most folks didn't know the half of what the government did with all the tax money it collected. But Barlowe had his suspicions. He figured a lot of that cash financed dirty work. Vast conspiracies, domestic and foreign. Secret plots and counterplots. Greedy, underhanded, fiendish stuff. He glanced at the tax documents in the seat beside him, and the vexation seemed to magnify. When he'd gone into H&R Block that morning, the accountant, a white man dressed sharply in a crisp shirt and tie, had smiled a big smile, like he had produced some financial masterpiece. Accountants, Barlowe thought now, slugging forward. Charge an arm and a leg for doing nothing. His taxes couldn't have required heavy lifting, and not for what that accountant charged. Please. He was a printer. An underpaid printer at that. In fact, he was so flat broke, he had considered doing his own returns. In the end, he decided to pay white folks to assume the risk. Let the government, the almighty Caesar, harass them if some decimals and zeros got mixed all up. Let Caesar go after them, not him. Barlowe wondered how Caesar would use his money against him this time around. He hated that feeling, not knowing the particulars about such things, giving his hard-earned coins to Caesar and in the blind. But what could a man do? You had to render unto Caesar what Caesar claimed as his. Either render or break the law and foolishly deliver yourself into Caesar's hands. He drove along, mulling Caesar. One day maybe he'd hit the number and get Caesar's foot off his neck. He slouched down in the seat a little, the top of his bushy head peeking just above the steering wheel. He covered two more city blocks and spotted a car that made him sit up straight. Barlowe couldn't see the driver clear. It was the make of the vehicle that he took notice of. It was a caddy. A gleaming, bright blue number with shiny rims and white walls scrubbed clean as a baby's butt. A caddy. When it came to hogging the road, caddy drivers were the worst. The caddy pulled out in front of him and settled into a lazy crawl. For several blocks, the driver loafed along like the street was named for him. Barlowe pressed in closer to send a message. The caddy kept gliding steady, like maybe the driver was masturbating behind the wheel. There was an American flag sticker pasted dead center in the car's back window. Barlowe grunted. Even more than taxes and Caesar, he hated flags. Ever since the plane struck, the things had sprung up everywhere. Houses, buildings, clothes, you name it. Flags were attached some way. He thought about that now as he trailed the caddy. The Patriot finally flashed a turn signal, swung a sharp right, and disappeared. Barlowe reached the post office and glanced at his watch. That caddy had thrown his timing off. Every tax season, he waited until the final day, April 15th, and for good measure, he got to his neighborhood post office only minutes before they locked the doors at 5 o'clock. Inside, a white man, the supervisor, greeted him with a stale smile.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.